Really bite, and that principle is Jesus Christ. And seeing the multitude, he went up into a mountain, and when he was sent, his disciples came unto him, and he opened his mouth and taught them, saying, Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. Blessed are they which are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for there is the kingdom of heaven. And finally said, Blessed are ye when men shall revile you and persecute you, and shall say all manner of evil against you falsely for my sake. He said, Rejoice and be exceeding glad, for great is your reward in heaven. For so persecuted they the prophets which were before you. My brethren, we are the salt and the light of the earth. We are the salt and the light of the earth. Only Christian knows what it means to be the salt and the light of the earth. He said, I have not come to abolish the law, I have come to fulfill the law.
You are hypocrites.
I'm not a hypocrite.
You are a hypocrite.
I am not. I am a child of the Most High God. I'm telling the truth.
Why do you back to the
world? I'm telling the truth. And the truth is, it's hurting you because you don't know Jesus. Jesus Christ said in John chapter 14, he says, Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And we say, I go you now, and the way you now. Thomas the doubter, he says, Lord, we don't know whither thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto Thomas, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Jesus Christ went before you, my friend. He went in and he came out. That's why we don't fear death. We do not fear death. You know why? Because Jesus Christ went in and he came out. He went in. Jesus Christ. Well, God bless you, my friend. May the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of Jesus Christ. That's my prayer for Muslims who abuse me. That's my prayer for Muslims who abuse me. May the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of Jesus Christ.
You're an unbeliever, that's why you don't fear death, man.
We are an unbeliever, but we do not curse you. You are the one who cursed us. It's Ramadan. It's Ramadan. Why do you curse me?
We all have to die one day. You're not going to live.
Why you're going to die because you have no Jesus?
But
we don't die.
We
Christians, we do not die.
What do you do then?
We do not die.
You do not die. What happens?
We do not die. We will fall asleep.
What's with all the cemeteries?
We will fall asleep.
Why are cemeteries for?
In Revelation, in John chapter 11, verse 25 and 26, Jesus Christ said, "I am the resurrection and the life." He that believes in me, though he were dead, yet he shall live. And whosoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Believest thou this? Lazarus was dead for 4 days. 4 days Lazarus was dead. And when the news came to Jesus, he came to the town. He didn't pray. He didn't say, Father, where is Lazarus? He came to the tomb. He said, Show me, where did you lay Lazarus? Martha said, Lord, by now he smells because he has been in the tomb for 4 days. He said, Master, show me, where did you lay him? He came to the tomb and he said, Roll away the stone. They were all shocked. Non-believer, Pharisees, Sadducees, scribes, they were hypocrites. He said, Roll away the stone. They were all shaking. They were all so shaking because they didn't believe Jesus. He said, Roll away the stone. They roll away the stone. He went to the tomb, to the door. He said, Lazarus, come forward. Lazarus, come forward. He came forward. This is my God. Jesus Christ, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, is
dead.
He said, No, he's alive. He's alive. He is risen forevermore.
He's dead.
He's risen forevermore. And he has given us eternal life. In John chapter 10, verse 28, he said, And I give unto them eternal life. To you. And he said, I give them eternal life. And they shall never perish. Neither shall any man pluck them out of my hand. When you are safe for eternity. No Muslim, no religion, no philosophy, no any God as the gospel, apart from the gospel of Jesus Christ, can take away the love of God from you. You know why? Because in Romans chapter 8, it says, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword, as it is written, for thy sake, we are killed all the day long. We are counted as a sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. For I am persuaded, neither death, nor life, nor angel, nor principalities, nor power, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
I am alive. I was once dead. Amen. I was once lost. I was once in my trespass. I am ex-Muslim. 30 years I beg Allah. 30 years I ask Allah. Silent. I am alive in Jesus Christ. Who shall separate me from the love of Christ? Who?
Nothing.
No one.
Nothing.
No principality.
No dark
power.
Power.
No things present. No things to come. God no height. No depth. No any God other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus.
You need some deliverance for your feet. You
don't
need
you
some
know in Philippians chapter 2?
You need some healing.
The Lord Jesus
for your
Christ says through Apostle
Paul,
every knee shall bow. Every tongue shall confess. Every knee shall bow.
You need some deliverance.
That Jesus
you need some
Christ
healing for that
Lord
foot.
To the glory of God.
You need some healing yes. for that foot.
Let's just mind
you. Need
in
some
you.
Healing for this. This
Jesus
needs
Christ
some healing.
Said through Apostle Paul, he says, let's just mind be in you.
Jesus, the
which was
also
in Christ
God
Jesus, who
be
in the form of God, so in no robbery, to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, and took upon him the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men, and be found in fashion as a man. He humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Wherefore God also has highly exalted him. And